And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Metropolitan Honor, Mr. Bernie Fershpan.
Welcome, everybody. Good evening, everybody. 5 years ago, when I was announced, you could hear a pin drop. Welcome. I feel like you're all mishpocha to me. I swear to God, I feel like this is my second bar mitzvah. I'm going to go around the table. We're going to take pictures. My dais is right here. So tonight we're having a party. I mean, it's a real party. Hi, Pam. Hello. I love Pam. Is Ann Dawson right behind you? I love Ann. I love this whole table. Oh, my God. My favorite people are here. We are going to have fun tonight. This is our way of saying thank you. Yeah, I like that. Thank you. I'm going to start to sing, I guess. This is our way of saying thank you. Not bad. Anybody here give lessons? Wow, okay. That was beautiful. Don't stop. Thank you, JP. Thank you. Okay, I got a few things I'd like to say. We had, this is my Metropolitan Room State of the Union address. Like every 5 seconds, you got to applaud and stand up, okay? So, all right, so this was a challenging year, I must say, wasn't it? This is good timing to have this party. Wouldn't you agree that we're all together here having a good time? We had a wonderful year, but it was challenging. We had debates. We had elections. I mean, it affects business, as you know. It affected everybody. Everybody here knows that, right? There was an explosion on the corner. There's New York City construction. Traffic and more traffic. There is economic turmoil, crazy weather patterns, subway failures, and yet we survived. Okay, this is your. Now you have to applaud and stand. Yay! This is my State of the Union address. Leslie! And you know what they say about survivors? They come out stronger, more passionate, more grateful, more appreciative. So that's my message for you today. I need some melodramatic music now. And we're thrilled to have you with us tonight. To celebrate the possibilities that 2017 will bring. Thank you. That's my State of the Union address. And now for a sad note. We have to get rid of the sad note, but there is a sad note, and I do want to mention it. We've experienced some very painful losses. And it's apparent at the Metropolitan Room that several people are missing, and we miss them dearly, so I'd like to just take a moment to mention their names. And that memorial back there is for Dana Lorge. And we miss her. I know Paul is here. Paul is here somewhere. And Warren Shine. There they are. Thank you, guys. Also, Paul facilitated us getting Dana's candelabras. Thank you, Paul. Okay, we have Russ Weatherford, everybody. Barbara Levy, Peter Levy's wife. Five-ish Finkel. Andrew Martin, for those of you who knew him. Our goal for 2017, the year of live performance. The Met Room will be working on new heights of awareness of live performance. We will have more artist support from Metropolitan Room. We will have better makeup in the dressing room, hairspray. Thank you. It is bright, isn't it? Could you just remember to shut it off when you leave the room? Okay, better experience for patrons and fans. Yay. This is a State of the Union address. Let me remind everybody. I need my vice president behind me, don't I? Mm-hmm. Like Joanne should be standing right there staring. She's downstairs doing your food. Don't complain. Okay, more classes. We will provide more classes on organizing your career and business. This is a mishpucha here. We really do care about performers. We want to help you as much as we can. We want to use our resources to give you whatever you need to make yourself a, you know, better entertainer, improve your business skills, more networking opportunities, more showcases. I'm going to be bringing back Bernie Sing Your Heart Out. How many here remember that? That was a great showcase. It launched a lot of careers. And at the end of next year, we're going to break another world record. Yeah, we broke a world record. You know, we did the longest variety show. We had about 350 performers. Next year, we're going to go for more. Maybe 500, who knows? We'll see. But we're going to break another record. In addition to our popular dishes, such as the Dip Trio, Caprese Salad, Bruschetta Medley, Dip Trio, Chip Duet, the Metropolitan and Cheese Cabaret, we're going to be adding, listen to this, to our food menu, starting the first, Eggplant Rollatini. Yeah, a little Italiano. And then for the Jews in the room, we're going to be doing Stuffed Cabbage. Whoa. Come on, Mark Nadler, what do you think? Stuffed Cabbage? Nadler, Stuffed Cabbage, what do you think?
That's great, I'm thrilled.
Okay, good. I don't mean to interrupt your fressing. We're going to have two chicken dishes. Yay. Yay for chicken, huh? Any chickens in the room here? Anybody from Brooklyn? Okay. Let's see. We're going to have grilled panini and pizza. Who would think that we would do pizza here? But why not? They have the personal pies, and we're going to do that. We're going to have lasagna. Come on. It's good stuff, right? So you're going to be testing some, but not all, of what we're going to be offering. But you'll be, trust me, you'll be stuffed. What are you eating right there?
I'm eating a panini. It's fabulous.
You love it, Brian? Brian Summers, everybody, loves the panini. Okay, take his word for it. And of course, we're going to be continuing our popular drink, the Joanne. Of course, I get to have my personal Joanne after midnight with a shot of vodka. Mac members will be getting a discount for the cover charge. Not the cover charge, the food and beverage minimum. Mac members. If you're not Mac members, become one. It's worth it. Mac members are going to be getting a discount. Well, Tom, it has to go through Tom's approval. You got to show your card. Tonight, I'll have the following musical directors. This is a party, so, you know, have some fun. Walk around. There's going to be some piano bars downstairs while there's entertainment upstairs. We're expecting maybe 150 people throughout the evening, so enjoy yourself, have some fun. I want to give a big thank you to Mr. Peter Levy. Where are you, Mr. Peter Levy? There he is. I want to thank him for what he's done for this community. He is the publisher of Cabaret Scenes, if you don't already know. He's been contributing his own personal funds to keep that magazine alive, so that there would be cover stories, there would be featured stories, featured articles. So if you have had an article in Cabaret Scenes, please thank Mr. Peter Levy, okay? Personally, thank him. I'd like to also thank my wife, Joanne Firshpan, who is such a hard worker. I can't keep up with her. I mean, 6 o'clock in the morning, she literally shakes me out of bed. Let's go, we gotta get going. We got food to get, we got emails to answer. She's terrific, she's a big support. And so I wanna thank her personally. She's downstairs working with the staff, getting the food ready for you guys. And she's also selected and tested a lot of the food for this evening. I'd also like to thank Mr. Beck Lee. Where's Mr. Beck Lee? Yeah. I gotta say that being a publicist is a thankless job. It really is, isn't it? It really is a thankless job because it's sort of like you're in the background. Many times you don't get the recognition that you deserve. And we always recognize what you've done for this club. And I want to thank you personally in front of everybody for all the hard work and the innovativeness that you've come up with, the creativity, for doing a fabulous job in promoting our shows here.
It's worth it.
It's worth it. Oh, yeah. I'd like to thank my son, Jonathan Firshpan, who is right now videotaping this event. He set up, he did something for this club that I didn't think of, and I'm jealous, but I'm proud of him. He thought of bringing in the 6-camera system and setting up a control room downstairs, and he does a fabulous job. If you've had it done, you know how great it is, right? Give him a hand if you've had it done. If you haven't done Jonathan, do Jonathan. You got to do. He's terrific. He really is terrific. He knows how to edit correctly. He knows exactly how, you know. He put a camera up here, and so he pans the audience. It's a beautiful thing that he does. He really. And Rachel, who also works for him. So we got to thank Rachel. I want to thank my very dear friend, J.P. Perot, for wherever he is. He's probably outside getting a drink somewhere. Oh, there he goes, at BXL. You can always, if you don't find him here, you know to look for him at BXL, okay? He's having either bone marrow or he's saying, I love it. Thank you, JP. That's so sweet of you. I love you. Okay, but no, terrific. And Johnny Mercado, for those of you who've worked with Johnny, right? Did I forget anybody? So tonight we have Steve Sandberg on the piano. Steve Sandberg, brilliant and talented guy. We have Frances Minerick. I don't know if she's here yet. She may not be. She may have canceled. I'm not sure. John Delphin. I know John is here. John Delphin. We have the one and only Lydia. Lydia Sebasto. Did I say it right? Hi, Billy Rowe. How you doing? Okay, I'm almost done, guys, okay? Because I know we got to get the show going over here. So this year has been full of what we call innovation and diversity. And next year, we're striving to have some more. So I'd like to just take in one breath. I want to see how many names I can mention of some of the performers that graced our stage this year. We've had. Ready? One breath. And I'm not mentioning everybody, but these are some innovative and creative artists and those that have actually taken residency here at the club. Okay, you ready? Marilyn May, Ed Asner, Marty Allen, Five-ish Finkel, the late Five-ish Finkel, Kathy Tricoli, Annie Ross, Melba Moore, Julie Budd, Carol Woods, Vivian Reed, Baby Jane Dexter, Linda Pearl, Anita Gillette, Penny Fuller, Tom Wopat, Frenchie Davis. Another breath. Okay. Porter Carroll, Kelly Wright, Barbara Fasano, Jive Aces, Savannah and Chase, Stacey Sullivan, and of course her producer, Joe Macchia. Joe Macchia, where are you? I want to thank Joe Macchia for doing a fabulous job. If you've been through Joe, if you've been booked through Joseph Macchia, there he is. I want to thank you, Joseph, for doing a brilliant job and throwing yourself birthday parties and what kinds of shows for you? Yeah. Okay, here we go. Jason Graw, Minda Larson, Peggy Sarlin, Dora Rubin, Marissa Mulder, Charles Baran, Hats Off to Liza, Tom Tochi's songwriter shows, John Minnick, Jeff McCauley, J.C. Driesen, Karina Sowers, Adler, Francesco Palladino, Felix Cabrera, Ron Dabney, Miss Hope Springs, Charlie Romo, Celia Burke, Steve Washington, Perez, Arlene Wolf. Another breath. Okay, this is, again, the State of the Union address. I have to, you know, talk about our accomplishments. Okay, maybe two more breaths and we're done. Devorah Bailey, Adrian Hahn, Rebecca Angel, Gabriel Stravelli, Jaime Lozano, Peter Molitrio, Jim Brochu, Steve Shacklin, Rafa Reyes, Blake Zolfo. Blake Zolfo, how many here know Blake Zolfo? Great talent. Billy Rowe, Brian Gary, Lisa Jason, Paula Dion Ingram, Ann Dawson, Lee Day. Lee Day did a pet cabaret here. Never in history has there been a pet cabaret. We can claim that we had a pet cabaret here. And we had, let me tell you, The audience loved the show. I'm telling you, the pets loved, absolutely loved her, including me. No, we didn't have to clean up. They were holding it in. They were so excited. Okay, here we go. Almost done. Karen Levitt, Aaron Moshida, James Rogers, did I mispronounce it? Irenka Jakubayek, Sandra Bargman, sorry. I know she's here. Iris Williams, Larry Kirchner, Joan Belgrave, Stearns Matthews, Paul Binder, Lena Orfanos, Shelley Birch, Chuck Sweeney, and David Majorco. They're doing a great show called Lee Squared. Susan Jeffries, Reverend Yolanda, Jillian Lorraine, Matt Beckoff, who has brought in Larry Storch, Charlie Gracie, The Crystal, Siobhan's, Rutanya, and Margaret Williams. What a great lineup that he's brought. Hedda Lettuce, Ellie, the king of Broadway. Mazel tov. You got to come and see his Hanukkah show coming up next week. You got to join Joanne and I because we love it. He brings latkes to die for and donuts. Sufganiyot, if you don't know what that is, but to die for. But his shows are fabulous, and I didn't know how funny you are. You are so funny and entertaining. Thank you so much. So come on down, join Joanne and I. It's a lot of fun. Sean Moninger, Dorothy Bishop, and then a couple of series that we've been very successful with, and that includes Everything Old is New Again with David Kenny, right? International Cabaret Festival. Richard Holbrook, Bobby Horowitz's series is Just a Number. This Is Your Night, Stephen Hank's hugely successful run of Cabaret's greatest hits. Stephen, you brought some really good stuff here, so thank you for making this club even better. Metro Star Talent Challenge, Metro Minor, Cabaret Cares, The Q, Scott Siegel presents New York's Next Top Drag Queen Contest. We have the Hot House Awards here for the best jazz musicians. We do it right here at the Metropolitan Room of all clubs in the city. We have the Bravo Musical Directors, the piano bars in the lounge. And I want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas, a Happy Hanukkah, and a Happy New Year. God bless all of you. God bless all of you. Marilyn May will be doing two shows, the 7:30. Oh, thank you, sweetheart. Thank you so much. You are Miss Hawaii. Was that Miss Hawaii? I remember. Thank you. And you were part of our 60-hour marathon. Okay. So more series, more celebrities, more performers, more culture, more support for you guys, more fun. Let's get the show started. You guys ready? Let's get the party started. I'm the boring part. A little music to... Hey! Yeah. How are you, sweetie? Queen Diva is in the house. What? You want to say something? What? Oh. Give him a hint? He wants me to give you guys a hint. Peter Levy wants me to... Just be on the lookout for some great news from Metropolitan Room. That's all I got to say. I can't say it. Wait, oh no, here he comes, Peter Levy.
Oh, have we got plans for you. Be patient. We'll tell you soon.
We'll tell you soon, and when you hear about it, you'll say, that's what they're talking about. Okay, it's good stuff, it's great stuff. 2017 is going to be a great year, it really is, for all of us. Think positive, visualize good things. Seriously, folks, don't dwell on the negative. Keep moving forward, or you stay stagnant. Keep moving forward. Life is for the living. Life is for the living. So just keep living, have fun. It's, you know, a lot of us look and search for the understanding of what life is all about, right? We get frustrated trying to figure it out. We have scientists, we have philosophers, we have religious folks trying to figure it out so that we can be calm and relaxed. But you know what it's all about? It's all about just be alive. Just be alive. Have fun. Follow your dreams. Because life's too short, people. Life's too short to argue. Stop the argument, goddammit. Stop the argument. It's a waste of your time. Enjoy the people around you. Appreciate what you have, not what you don't have. It's all relative. It's all relative. The person without the shoes should look at the person without the feet. That's right. There are plenty of people who wish they had your problems. You know, I pray for the people in Aleppo, Syria, those poor people who are, you know, ravaged and right? And the whole culture is destroyed over there. And there's innocent women, children, and men, and kids out there who are suffering. So I don't want to get too political here. I'm just saying, seriously, enjoy life. Don't get caught up in the small stuff, okay? Don't sweat it. Have fun. That's what live entertainment is all about. You work hard all week. You spend a few dollars to have fun and share this experience with all of us. So let's continue the joy. Okay, I'm going to bring up to the stage one of our favorite new artists here at the Metropolitan. She's terrific, and she's got a great guy behind her playing the piano. So please help me welcome to the stage the lovely and talented Peggy Sarlin.
Hello. As Bernie so accurately told you, I am Peggy Sarlin. And say hello to the man I call Maestro, Jeff Franzell. Now, this time of year is a very good time to look back and assess and evaluate and take stock. And you ask yourself, who am I? Where am I going? What am I doing? Unfortunately, I have a song for that. So you may have heard Bette Midler sing this song. You may have heard Patti LuPone sing this song. But I wrote the song. It's my song. So now you're going to hear me sing it. God help you. I've lived my own life, win or lose. No one's ever called the shots for me. I put myself into these shoes, and no one's ever tied the knots for me. Life's a banquet, so I ate. Piled experience on my plate. Grab love's gleaming golden cup and drank it down, bottoms up. So proudly now I turn and face the crowd and sing my feelings very loud. I regret everything. Every moment of my life, every step that I take is another big mistake. I regret everything. There is nothing I've done right. Summer, winter, fall, or spring, I regret everything. The one good man that got away, my acting in the high school play, that time at lunch I dropped my tray, my history of tooth decay. The love I gave one reckless night, the pants I bought that were too tight, that time I ran the traffic light, the Chinese food I ate last night. Pardon. I regret everything, every single thing I've done, every path that I choose only leads to more blues. I regret everything. Look, my stocking has a run, summer, winter, fall. depressed you. I shouldn't have come.
Thank you, Peggy. Give it up for Peggy Sarlin and Jeff Franzell, the fabulous Jeff Franzell. By the way, Jeff has brought in some amazing talent to the club. I want to thank you for that. Thank you so much.
I want to thank you for supporting us, wonderful artists.
Oh, you are wonderful. There's no doubt about it. You guys are wonderful. I love all of you. Up next is we're going to have a little fun. We attempted, you know, you got to try everything. Some things you got to throw against the wall if it sticks. This one didn't stick yet. I have a funny feeling there's something I didn't do. But we're going to figure it out. But it's a great show. It's a great series. It's called A Sing-Along. And it's a fun time. It's almost like a piano bar on a larger scale. But I'd like to bring up to the stage one of the most successful sing-alongs that we did have here. And that would be Jay, Aaron, and John. Please come up to the stage.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the original sing-alongers, as it were. So we did try the experiment. We tried singing along. A lot of people, not that many people came, but they enjoyed it when they did come. I think other people are going to do the same experiment of having people come and we put up the words. Do we have the words tonight, JP?
Yes, we do.
So excited.
I'd like to know which word you want first.
You know, John McMahon knows every song ever written, and if he doesn't, he has the fake book that tells him. But we have chosen a program that we would like to share with you. Now, it's not your normal Christmassy sing-along. We're sort of not doing, like, the Jeebus thing or the Buddha thing or the Jewish thing. We're just happy, you know, carefree songs. And I think the best example is the one from The Grinch That Stole Christmas. You know this song? Favu Fares? Does anyone know this? Do you? We're going to put it up so you can sing
along. As soon as you tell me which song you want on the screen, I will put it.
Welcome Christmas, please.
Thank you very much.
Christmas. Yes, it's called Welcome Christmas.
Look,
and there's music. So if you don't know it, surely you'll catch on. Shirley, let's see how it goes, shall we?
Stop calling me Shirley.
All right, Shirley.
Here we go.
Hey, I'll move over here.
Ready?
Favu Fares, Favu Dores, welcome Christmas, come this way. Favu Fares, Favu Dores, welcome Christmas, Christmas Day.
Welcome, Favu Fares, welcome, welcome, Favu Dores, Christmas Day. In our grasp, so long as we have hands to clasp.
Sing the chorus!
Favu Fares, Favu Dores, welcome Christmas, bring your cheer. Favu Fares, Favu Dores, welcome Fares, far and near.
That was beautiful. Give yourselves a round of applause. The Favu Dores song.
You're a gay one, Mr. J.
Thank you so much. And so now, John, you have a little specialty number that we're going to introduce to you. John has, in answer to the 12 days of Christmas, actually.
I want to do this. I used to do this in the piano bars when I worked at Don't Tell Mamas for 15 years. And I want to do this because I haven't been able to do it in years. And we do the 8 days of Hanukkah to the melody of the 12 days of Christmas. And the great thing is, it's faster. 8 days. Not
and
much.
Only 8 days.
Not much, but it is, okay?
Yeah.
What's a good key for everybody?
That's pretty.
Is that too high?
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Should we do that? Yeah, that's for Jay Rogers. Okay, so here we go. On the first day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me a bagel with a little chive shmear. Okay, and what you have to know is everything has a gesture. So when we do the chive shmear, you're putting the chive shmear on the bagel. And every time we say it, because we're going to go through every verse, we're going to get to Shmia. You have to do a really Long Island accent for Shmia. That's got to like really open up at the end.
That's nice, honey.
It's a good singing vowel of all of them. Okay. So we'll try that again from the beginning. Okay.
On the first day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me a bagel with a bagel chive shmear. On the second day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me,
you pat your head,
two yarmulkes and a bagel with a little chive shmear. On the third day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me,
pat them out,
three potato latkes, two yarmulkes, and a bagel with a little chive shmia.
I really open that. Okay, I really appreciate it. Open that vowel.
That's nice, John.
Because I'm a vocal coach. Okay.
On the fourth day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me.
We're going
to
roll them now.
Four cinnamon rugula, three potato latkes, two yarmulkes, and a bagel with a little chive shmear.
But just a little, I'm on a diet. Could you just cool back on the shmear? Okay,
let's go up a little bit. On the fifth day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me five golden rings.
That stays the same. Funny, right?
Four cinnamon arugula, three potato latkes, two yarmulkes, and a
bagel with a little chive shmear.
Oh, you're doing so well. On the sixth day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me.
Now we're going to make bold, or you can do the cough joke.
Six matzo balls, five golden rings. Four cinnamon rugula, three potato latkes, two yarmulkes,
and a bagel with a little chive shmear.
Can I go up another step? Come on, you tenors.
On the
seventh. Oh, wait, we go to the seventh day because Elaine Breyer at Don't Tell Mom has helped me put this together, and she said somewhere around the sixth or seventh day, they've run out of ideas and you get a gift certificate. So that's what we're going to do.
On the seventh day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me.
Stretch it out.
Seven gift certificates, six matzo balls, five
chew on it.
Golden ring from Fortunoffs. Four cinnamon rugula, three potato latkes, two yarmulkes,
and a bagel
chive shmear.
Okay, this is the last one. Make it worth it.
On the eighth day of Hanukkah, my true love gave to me
eight
slices of lox, seven gift certificates, six matzo ball,
from Fortunoffs,
and four cinnamon rugula, three potato latkes, two yarmulkes, and a bagel with a little chive shmear.
Oi!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
So that was that. I'm so glad I got that out of my system.
Me too, John. It was thrilling.
Wasn't that
and
fun?
Exciting, wasn't it?
Mark Nadler, you want that. You can have it. It's all yours.
I would never.
I don't
so
blame
diplomatic.
You.
So diplomatic. Our final selection for the evening is a song you all know and love, made popular by Leroy Anderson, who wrote it, right?
Yeah.
He didn't make it popular, but I'm sure the Wurlitzer organ did. And we'd like you all to sing along with us, but we're doing the Steve and Edie version. So Steve is in green and Edie's in red. Now you probably know it. So you decide, I'm going to sing Edie, he's going to sing Steve. So you can either sing with Aaron or me and John.
Well, we have this fantasy that it's Steve and Edie guesting on Judy Garland's television show. And at some point late in the song, she starts sticking in forget your troubles, get happy for no reason at all. And they don't want her doing it, but she does it anyway. So I occasionally may join in with some of that.
You never know.
Okay, here we go.
Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring ting tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Together with you.
Come on, it's sleigh ride, sleigh ride. Calling you who?
Singing you who?
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Together with you. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go. It's starting to snow. No, it's not.
We're riding in a wonderland of snow.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, it's grand, just holding your hand.
We're riding along with the song of a wintry fairyland. Our cheeks are
nice and rosy and comfy cozy
are we.
We're snuggled up together like a bird of a feather would be. Just take the road before us and sing a chorus or two.
Sing a chorus or two.
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. There's a birthday party at the home of Farmer Gray. It'll be the perfect ending of a perfect day.
We sing the songs we love to sing without a single stop by the fireplace as we watch the chestnuts pop.
A pop, pop, pop. There's a happy feeling nothing in the world can buy.
I love it.
When they take around the coffee
more, sir.
Pumpkin pie.
Print of Courier and I.
These wonderful things are the things we remember all through our lives. Just see those sleigh bells ringing, ting, ting, tingling too.
Hallelujah, baby.
It's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Hallelujah, baby.
Sleigh bells ringing, ting, ting, tingling too.
Hallelujah, baby.
It's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Together with you. Hey,
sleigh ride, sleigh ride.
Oh, look out! Look out, Edie! Watch out, Steve!
Yay! Happy sleigh ride, everybody! Woo! Happy holidays! Jay. Happy New Year! Happy everything! We'll that see you Jay, later on!
Jay, Aaron, and John! Together is Jedge. I'd like to acknowledge somebody in the audience who has been taking a slight hiatus, but he said he's coming back next year. We love him dearly. One of the nicest guys. One of the most fun shows. Please give it up for Joey Infante. Yay, Joey. Up next, please help me welcome one of the most talented and brilliant performers here. She did a great run on, what was that, Billy Joel. That's right. Please help me welcome to the stage Pam Lewis.
Some folks like to get away, take a holiday from the neighborhood, hop a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood. I'm just taking a greyhound on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind. I've seen all the movie stars in their fancy cars and their limousines. I've been high in the Rockies under the evergreens. I'm in a Christmas state of mind. It was so easy the New York Times, the Daily News. When it comes down to reality, it's fine with me, I'll let it slide. I don't care if it's Chinatown or up on Riverside. I'm in a den of lords kind of mind.
Sebasto.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, we love you.
Happy holidays, everybody.
Up next is a gentleman of gentlemen's. Did I say that right? He was Dana Lorge's partner, a good friend of all of us, a mensch and a half, and he's got a heart. So please give it up for Mr. Warren Shine.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sweetheart. Miss America 1972. You look gorgeous. I got to tell you, this has been one hell of a year. November 17th, I'm rushed to North Shore Hospital. I had a quadruple bypass. You two, why don't try to top me. What are you, Stephen Hanks, for crying out loud? Stephen? No, but he's next Thursday. You ever tell somebody, I mean, this was serious stuff. I'm laying there having an angiogram, and the doctor says, you got to have open heart surgery. And the surgeon is Peggy Easton. I said, first of all, I don't need diabetes and have chocolate. And I tell you, I got enough holes in me now, boy. I think you need glasses, Peggy. I don't know what. No, I love her. She sent me a beautiful note. The rest of you suck. No, I really did this. But you know what the best therapy to make you feel better? You're standing on this stage 5 weeks. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. And I want to thank everybody who called me and sent me a card. Could have sent fruit. But it's very nice to be here. A nice piece of fruit. Instead, I see Peggy with Richard and Dan at the Chocolate Festival at the Mitchell Field Complex in Long Island. Boy, you'll go anywhere for a ride. Well, you're put out. This is what happens. So, that's right. You can. I heard. You're such a dick. But to be here, and they even iron the sheet for me. You see, Joanne has an Orthodox decorator. But it is. It's nice. It's not, but this is a special. You like that, Bobby? I'm glad I woke you up. You and Ann Dawson, they're both like this. I can't believe it. But Tatala, but it's nice. It's really nice. This is a special time of year. It's very special. And special songs at the holiday time. And so far, actually, I was going to do the Pam Lewis songbook tonight. But I decided I wasn't dying my hair, you gorgeous doll. And you are gorgeous and talented. Thank you. When I grow up. That's right. December 31st, I'll be 65 years old. I'm now on Medicare. I can get as sick as I want. Let the government pay for it. But it's... it's... Oh, does this hurt? But it's nice to be here. And we should really have some Christmas songs. I find it interesting that two of the most famous Christmas songs ever written by two Jews... White Christmas, the number one song. Who wrote it? Irving? Ellie, right? That's right. And the second one was co-written by my idol, a gentleman who I got to work with once, who I go back on tour in the spring with my new Mel Torme show. He wrote that on a hot August day in L.A., 1949. Song never went anywhere till one day he was playing it in a studio at Capitol Records. The door to the studio is open. Who walks by? Nat King Cole. He said, I want that song on my Christmas album. And until the day Mel Torme died, he loved Nat King Cole. Because of the royalties he made on that song, he could pay alimony to five wives. So it was worth something. But I haven't gotten my chops back, but you'll know this song. So why don't we kind of all do it together with myself and the beautiful Lydia Sylvester. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimo.
Everybody knows I'm from Vienna, mistletoe. Help to make this season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow.
That's enough on your show off. I know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies in his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know. So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids. from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas, Sei be gesund. Everybody have a healthy, happy, Randy Seven Names. It's good to see you. Everybody have a great holiday season. Be well. Thank you so much. Thank you, Bernie and Joanne. Bernie.
Hey. By the way, your surgeon, Peggy, sings better than you.
It's the story of my life.
Warren Shine, everybody. Warren Shine. And up next, we have one of the most loved individuals who has a series here at the Metropolitan Room. She's had series since I've been here for the last 5 years. Please help me welcome the wonderful Bobby Horowitz. Yes, Bobby Horowitz, it's your turn. Did you forget? Oh, she's got music. Give it up for Bobby Horowitz. How's everybody doing? You having fun? How do you like the food, huh? You want some more? Okay. We don't have any. Sorry. Just kidding. Oh, what a cute dog.
What? He wants more food.
Oh, he wants more. Who's playing? Did you? Oh, do you need a piano player? Do we have any volunteers? Warren, do you know how to play the piano? Okay. Okay. John Delphin, please. Give it up for John. John is the volunteer. He's a terrific guy. Always there when we need him. He's terrific.
David Friedman wrote the music. You know David. Well, David always saw me coming in. I should bring some stuff up here. I always had shopping bags, you know, from different places. And he always said, why do you do that? And I said, well, it's important. And he said, well, let me put some music to it. Can you read it? This
meant never. You want to give me a tempo?
Yeah. If you wanna know the reason I shop, and I shop until I drop, and even then I'll never stop. I'm doing it for America, doing it for America. It's not about me needing lots of stuff. That would never be enough to keep me shopping. Shopping's tough. I'm doing it for America. Doing it for America. So follow my lead and buy a hat that's a cutie, and of course a gorgeous suit and a bag that's a beauty. Know with every purchase you'll be doing your duty for America, America. I'm helping the economy shoe by shoe. Every shoe I buy means more for me and more for you. I'm buying them for America, buying them for America. And every time I buy a new designer dress, I can hear the GNP is saying yes, yes, yes. Buying them for America, buying them for America. Helping all of labor, I'm a retail business boomer. I'm helping my neighbor by dispelling any rumor that it is less than fabulous to be a consumer for America, America. I'm helping my country by filling my closet, cause I'm giving lots of stores lots of dollars to deposit. I'm filling them for America. America, you know, filling them for America. Then they can invest until the Dow hits the sky. I gotta do my best, I gotta give it a try. 'Cause when it comes to shopping, it's a case of do or die. For America, America. Go out and Randy, buy, buy, buy. Go out and buy, buy, buy. Go out and buy, buy, buy. Go out and buy, buy, buy. Buy, 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 buy. For America. Do it for America.
God bless Bobby Horowitz and America.
Him. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, up next is a gentleman that is truly a legend. He's a wonderful human being who's been very supportive of the Metropolitan Room. Please help me welcome to the stage Mr. John DeMarco.
I'm here, laryngitis and all. We'll get through it. Give me. We had the smiles. We had the tunes. We had a lovely, lovely afternoon. It was the next best thing to love. And though we fought, there was no pain. The sex was good, but never great. May I explain? And let me tell you, it was the next best thing to love. Something always missing. Christmas in LA. We could get to April, never May. And so at last, we let it go. Because it didn't take two geniuses to know. And it is better now. And it is now that I feel now. It was the next best thing. Never made sublime, still we should be so lucky all the time. So no regrets, forget the tears. I know a dozen guys who'd hang with you for years. And come to think of it, I guess the next best thing to love is really love, really love. I thought it was love. Thank you. Now, about 2 weeks ago, I was at Urban Stages to sing the same song. A third of the song went by and I went completely blank. I forgot every word.
but I kept on singing because I knew the melody. When I came off the stage, my friend Dan said to me, I like your version better. Thank you so much. Thank you, John.
John DeMarco, ladies and gentlemen. Up next is what I call a one-man band. He is incredible, one of the funniest guys, one of the most talented and brilliant entertainers. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Mark Nadler.
Warren says don't. Nobody tells me. You better watch out. Nobody cares if I cry. Because is somebody actually also singing at the same time?
Yes, Mark, I'm sorry. Let me close the door, yes.
I mean, not that I mind. I already missed the shrimp. There was shrimp that we missed. One thing I love, every bar mitzvah I've ever been to or played, there were mounds of shrimp. Jewish people will understand why that's ridiculous. Nobody tells me, you better watch out. Nobody cares if I cry, 'cause Santa Claus isn't coming to town. Not for this Jewish guy. Do you all remember a comic named Pudgy? Do you remember Pudgy? I loved her so much. The first time I went to see Pudgy, She said to me, I was sitting in the audience, and she came over to me and she said, take off your glasses. And I went, and she says, look at that, the nose stays on. I loved her. My Gentile friends all are having a ball. They've waited for this for a year. But I'm feeling low, as they wish for the snow. Because all I got's a bagel mit a schmear.
Oi.
A Jewish Christmas, that's my desire. I want a holiday to snuggle by the fire. I want a Yule log, not just some candles. A burning bush to heat my tush and warm my sandals. Then give us Christmas. We'll shout L'chaim. We want your elves all to ourselves. Is that a chaim with cookies baking in the oven? Who could mock us? Between the smelling and the kvelling, oy, such nachas. Those who like Purim, you can't ignore them. I'm sure they'll come along if we just lure them with old St. Nicholas, lots of gifts, the whole Megillah. Why be shmo, as the fat guy knows we like chinchilla. Please give us kishkas and some knishes. We don't want your figgy puddings on our dishes. Then ask the grocer if it is kosher, if we keep the eggnog separate from gefilte fishes. We want your Rudolph. We want your carols. We want to own your Christmas tunes. Locks, stocks, and barrels. We'll keep them sacred. Just do this favor. We'll only add a little angst to give them flavor. Boy, to the world. Envision Santa Claus at temple just to psych him. He doesn't preach or give a speech. Shalom, I like him. His velvet suit and furry hat are so inviting. Somewhere in Brooklyn Heights, a tailor is moonlighting. Please keep your fruitcake and ham with gristle. We'll get some deli, have a nosh, you'll eat a bissel. Don't be a putz, let one hand wash the other. Even Jesus had to please his Jewish mother. So let's talk turkey before I lose it. I'll make you such a deal you can't refuse it. But this thing you're telling me is so fricata. You mean a Tannenbaum's a tree and not a doctor? Now we don't do Ave Maria. But with some tweaking, we could sing it in Judea. We'll throw in Moses, take out Messiah. They'll get verklempt when we attempt Ave Maria. We've got a rabbi, you've got a savior. The fact that they're both lawnsmen's in our favor. Let's just enjoy this time. Well, thanks to our donation, what? You never knew, we put the Jew in jubilation. Then a Christmas. Please, I'll pay retail. I'll have my son, the lawyer, handle every detail. We'll work out papers around the table. A Jewish Christmas. There were no silent nights in my house growing up. A Jewish Christmas. And that's all I want.
And that was the one, the only Mark Nadler. We have some shrimp for you, Mark. Shrimp coming up. Please pass the shrimp to Mark. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome to the stage the fabulous Deborah Lynn Cole.
How the heck am I going to, shrimp or not, how the hell am I going to follow that? Okay, I'll try my best. Hi, everybody. Y'all looking like, who the hell is, this is very clicky. It's very clicky in here.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let the Yuletide,
figure, politically correct. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. The years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang the shiny star up on the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. Oh, 'cause here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. All through the years, we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang the shiny star and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. Right now, in the Metropolitan Room, right now, did you get your shrimp? Right now. Thank you, Lydia. I'm usually on the other side watching Lydia. So now this is a pleasure for me. Thank you so much. Thank you, Bernie.
You're very welcome. Deborah Lynn Cole.
Thank you.
Stay up there, Lydia. Stay up there. Because I'm going to bring up, I got to say, one of our favorite people, Joanne, and I absolutely love and adore, have become good friends with. And she's really done an incredible job here at the Metropolitan Room this past year and brought some incredible Barbara Streisand and other incredible singers. But she's got her own style, and she is it. So please give it up for J.C. Driesen.
Thank you so much. Hi, everybody. Oh, it's so good to be back at the Metropolitan Room. I missed you guys. Totally miss you guys. I just flew in from Florida. I should have stayed. It's a little chilly here, but I'm going back. So, but I had to be here because I love being at the Metropolitan Room, and I love all of you. Bernie and Joanne, you have been amazing to me, and I can't tell you how much that means to me. And we've created so many special moments here. So, like we're going to do again right now. This is the moment, this is the day, this is the moment when I know I'm on my way. Every endeavor I have made ever is coming into play. It's here and now, today. This is the moment, this is the time, when the momentum and the moment are in a rhyme. Give me this moment
I'll gather up my past and make some sense at last. This is the moment when all I've done, all of the dreaming, scheming, and screaming becomes one. This is the day. Just see it shine when all I've lived for becomes mine. This is the moment. This is the hour when I can open up tomorrow like a flower and put my hand to everything I plan to fulfill my grand design, see all my stars align. This is the moment, my final test. Destiny beckoned, I never reckoned second best. I won't look down, I must not fall. This is the moment of them all. For all these years I faced the world alone, and now the time has come to prove to them I've made it on my own. This is the moment, my final test. Destiny beckoned, I never reckoned second best. I won't look down, I must not fall. This is the moment, the sweetest moment. Was the moment, the greatest moment of them all. Thank you so much.
Woo. The beautiful J.C.
You get a little verklempt sometimes after you sing those songs. Thank you so much. Happy holidays, everybody. Lydia on piano, thank you.
I'd like to bring up to the stage a great friend of the Metropolitan Room who has created an alliance here at the Metropolitan Room for songwriters and a network and possibilities for these songwriters to do their own shows, to produce their own writing right here at the Metropolitan Room, to make their home right here. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Tom Tose.
So about 6 months ago, Bernie asked me to start a songwriter group, and we've been meeting twice a month. Bobby Horowitz is a proud member of the Songwriter Alliance, and there are a whole bunch of other great songwriters. And so all of you who are consumers of songs, whether you're singers or directors or producers or music directors, I believe so much in live music. I practically live in the Metropolitan Room, and I love live music. But live music and this kind of singing shouldn't just be museum pieces. We shouldn't just be singing songs from 100 years ago or 80 years ago. We should be singing songs in the here and now. The great Mark Nadler, you got your shrimp, right? I noticed as soon as he talked about shrimp on the stage, he got delivered a boatload of shrimp. And so now I would like to talk about the filet mignon. See what you can do. I'm over there. Mark, I thought, do you know John Forster, the great songwriter? John, okay, you should be doing a whole evening of John Forster. Really? So, well, you know, people think that songwriters are these elusive beings, and we're really not. We're writing away. We're dying to have you find us and find our songs. So I started the Songwriter Alliance. You want to meet a bunch of great songwriters? Talk to me. Talk to Bernie, who will put you in touch with me. And it's not anything sacred about the Alliance. There are plenty of other great songwriters besides the Alliance. But please, all of you, seek out new songs and seek us out, because we're, pardon? Yeah, we're not hard to find, and we want our songs to be sung. It's a method of communication, and well, anyway, so that's really the purpose of the Songwriter Alliance, is to foster camaraderie, collaboration, commiseration sometimes, just all kinds of really good things. And it's been a group that's been very meaningful to me and to all of the members. So come to our showcases, and thank you, Bernie. I described Bernie last night as the visionary managing director of the Metropolitan Room, and I do think
managing partner, if you don't mind.
All right, sorry. All right, managing partner. Okay, thanks, everybody.
Mr. Tom Tose. And speaking of songwriters, please help me welcome Mr. Brian Gary.
All right. First of all, boy, do I concur with Tom. Being a songwriter myself, and having been a songwriter since I was 12, it's always been a problem trying to get songs to people, and it shouldn't be. And this whole thing about the Great American Songbook should not stop at 1945, right? Well, that's about as many people as do the new songs. But I'd like to tell you a couple. First of all, I want to say how brave it was of Warren to get up here after only 1 month of being out of surgery. I was the one that yelled that I understood, because I had the same operation 4 years ago. And 1 month afterward, you're still in a lot of pain. You know, what's that? Tell that to your wife? You know, and if you sleep on your stomach, it's like the worst thing in the world, you know. You'll never sleep on your stomach until you heal. But it's a rough road. And, you know, I applaud him for getting up here and singing a song. I don't think I would have been able to sing a song a month later. Anyway, I also want to say thank you to Bernie and Joanne and JP, is that? Everybody who's associated with this room, and all the waiters that are here tonight that are working so hard. What a great bunch of people. What a really great bunch of people. I'd like to tell you a little quick story. This is not about the song I'm going to do, but I just would love to tell you this little tidbit of information about Christmas time and Christmas songs. My grandfather was on the radio for quite some time in the 30s and 40s, and very popular. And songwriters used to come to him to do their songs. And in 1934, I think it was, around November, these two songwriters came up to him and played him a song. And he thought it was good, but he didn't think it was quite right for him. And he was basically thinking about turning it down. And my grandmother went over to him and said, "Oh, Eddie, this song could be something very good for you." And he says, "Do you really think so?" The song was, "You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town." The first person to ever do that song was my grandfather, Eddie Cantor. So when I hear that song being done, You know, I realized that, you know, it was because of him. And you know something? He never recorded the song. Isn't that strange? Never recorded it. And that's why it's so funny when I hear somebody like Bruce Springsteen or who redoes the Phil Spector version and goes, Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa never was done that way originally, right? Right, Bobby? You know that too. So, in keeping with songwriters, since I said that I've been writing songs for quite some time, I wrote a song for my wife at Christmas time, and it's never been recorded. Christmas songs don't get recorded too often. But I always wanted to perform this song, and in fact, the next time I play here, I'm going to call it the annual Christmas show, because you get a much bigger audience if you say it's that, don't you think? Anyway, I thought this captured her her feelings and everything, and I think it may capture some of yours too. It's called Never Ending Christmas. She keeps the tree up, won't take it down. The lights stay on like a sparkling crown. It's what she wants, a never-ending Christmas. She's got the presents, they're all unwrapped, they're underneath, and the cats are trapped.
Mr. Brian Gary. And up next is the producer and host of our open mic here at the Met on Sundays. Please welcome Deb Berman. Please welcome Deb Berman.
Hi, I'm sorry it takes a while to get through the maze of drinkers over there. So, I do run an open mic here, and it's really a lot of fun. If anybody wants to come to the next one, it is Sunday, January 8th. We start at an ungodly early hour, but it's 12 noon, so come by. We have a lot of fun. This next song has absolutely nothing to do with the holidays. But I thought I'd share a little bit of my life with you. I've been divorced a while now, and I've been really happy with my, really, I don't know, you know, I'm really happy with me and my cats. I mean, us ladies, we have a really bad reputation, but screw that, it's fabulous. So what I found surprisingly was over the summer, something stirred in me, and I discovered I still have a little bit of rumba in my horn section. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that was quick. John Delphin. So what is a girl to do, right? You're in your prime, what are you gonna do? So I researched and I found out that there's this new dating app, and I'm into new things called Tinder. Does everyone know about Tinder? I don't want to bore you. Okay, so let me bore you. Tinder is an interesting dating app on your phone that has a GPS. So it literally finds you instant dates when the mood strikes. And you can check the profiles out on your phone. And it can find you a date who's close by in proximity. And you can even narrow it down by how far away they are and how old they are. And this was not like what I remembered when I was young and I just got set up on blind dates. This was fabulous. This is a whole different kind of blind dates.
Blind dating.
Oh, you're quick too, Miss Peggy. So one night, when I was in Midtown Manhattan, the mood struck, and I picked up my little phone, and I went on to Tinder, and I checked out some profiles, and if you don't know the rules, when you're looking at the pictures, if you like somebody, you swipe right, and if you're not interested in somebody, you swipe left, okay? And if you swipe right, and if they swipe right, that's a match, and you can immediately start texting each other. It's great. So I checked it out. I was swiping left a lot. Then I saw somebody and I swiped right. Ping, a text came. Like in a second, it's unbelievable. So I texted back and they texted back. And a whole 5 minutes went by of texting and we found out we were four blocks apart and he suggested that we meet. At the Russian Vodka Room on 57th off 8th. What the hell? So when I arrived at the restaurant, there was a very handsome, tall, well-dressed gentleman who said, Deborah. And he said, why don't we go over to the bar? And I said, what a wonderful idea. And we ordered drinks, and he said, so why don't you tell me a little about yourself? So I said, I like New York in June. How about you? I like a Gershwin tune. How about you? I like a fireside when a storm is due. I like potato chips, moonlight, and motor trips. How about you? I'm mad about good books. I can't get my fill. And Franklin Roosevelt's looks gave me a thrill. Holding hands in the movie show when all the lights are low. May not be new, but I like it. How about you? Oh, you want to know more about me? I like martini straight on the rocks too. I think Obama's great. How about you? Oh, that totally threw me. I gotta do it again now, right? I'm sorry. You don't clap, all right? It really throws me off. I'm not used to applause. Martini straight on the rocks too. I think Obama's great. How about you? I like a happy meal. It's sad but true. I like the Sunday Times shows that solve murder crimes. How about you? God, I like a rich desserts. Tiramisu. Maybe we'll bake a cake. I'll make it with you. Taking off in an airplane, France, Italy, or Spain, or Timbuktu. I'm up for anything new. Why don't you tell me a little about yourself? You like to sleep in late. I always do. You think Obama's great. That's 2 for 2. You own a penthouse on Fifth Avenue. You like a lady who always
stands up to you, that I can do. I am a one-man gal, I thought you should know. You like menage a trois. Oh, is that so? You own whips, a harness with a chain. Oi, I'm not fond of pain. I think we're through. Check, please. Who's paying?
How about you?
Deb Berman!
Happy holidays, everybody. Wishing you much love. Thank you.
How about you, Deb Berman? We're a bit more than halfway through, so let's keep this party going. For those that are coming up, we'll keep it short and sweet and to the point. Let's keep this party going. Please help me welcome Ann Dawson.
Happy holidays, everybody. So glad to be here celebrating with you. And I thought, being that the world is in such turmoil, it might be appropriate if I just remember how lucky I am to be alive. I feel groggy and weary and tragic. Punchy and bleary and fresh out of magic, but alive. I feel twitchy and bitchy and manic, calm and collected, choking with panic, but alive. I'm a thousand different people. Every single one is real. I've a million different feelings. Okay, but at least I feel. And I feel rotten yet covered with roses. Warm as Jamaica, smoking like Moses. Alive, that's the thing. I'm alive. I feel half Tijuana, half, what is it?
Younger than springtime.
Younger than springtime. Older, I may have. Glasses. Okay, that's good. I feel rotten yet covered with roses. Younger than springtime, older than Moses. Alive, that's the thing. I'm alive. This kaleidoscope of feelings whirls around inside my brain. I have to come back here. I'm so sorry, guys. At least I'll be letter perfect from here. Okay. I feel wicked and wacky and mellow. Firm as Gibraltar, shaky as Jell-O, but alive. I feel half Tijuana, half Boston. Partly Jane Fonda, partly Jane Austen. Alive, that's the thing. I'm alive. This kaleidoscope of feelings whirls around inside my brain. I admit I'm slightly cuckoo, but it's dull to be too sane. And I feel brilliant. fantastic, super fantastic, alive. Everybody. Thank you, John.
And Dawson, everybody. And Dawson. And
Happy New Year, everyone.
And I'd like to bring up to the stage somebody who you know. You know who he is. You've seen him on Facebook. You've seen him on Twitter. Please help me welcome to the stage the fabulous and talented booking manager here at the Metropolitan Room, Joseph Macchia.
Hi, everybody. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy New Year. Thank you so much for being here with us tonight. 9.5 years ago, I started here as a part-time host and worked my way up the ladder, and I'm so proud to be part of the Metropolitan Room and be the booking manager and get to spend each and every day with Mr. Bernie Frischpan, who has changed his club over the past 5 years. Thank you so much, Bernie. And 3 years ago, we brought my award-winning series, Cabaret Cares, here that benefits my charity. It's a monthly benefit series that helps children living with HIV and AIDS. And over the past 11 years now, we've raised over $170,000. And that's because of many of you in this room. I could not do it with you performers and people who come out month after month and support us. And we're back in January. We have two shows, New Beginnings and then the cast of On Your Feet. And then my new, again, gay talk show, The Q, is back here in January as well. So if you love The View but love gay men, come out and see The Q. And if anyone's looking for a date, I'm out in the lobby. I'll be booking shows, so come and see me after the party tonight. Have a wonderful holiday season. I love you all. Thank you so much for being here tonight.
Oh, it's my turn. You said nice things about me? Could you repeat them? All righty. Please help me welcome one of the best jazz singers in town, Maria Guida. Come on, everybody. Maria Guida.
Hi, everybody. I am thrilled to be here. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. Happy New Year. And I want to say that I love the Metropolitan Room. It is my favorite place to sing. And I know it's your favorite place to sing, too. And I want to thank Bernie and Joanne for always welcoming me here. I feel like it's my home. It's beautiful. It's so beautiful. And Joseph and the whole crew and JP on sound, who's a genius over there in the booth. So you're going to be hearing my band playing along, and this is James Wideman on the piano, Essiet on the bass, and Tony Moreno on the drums.
I love the East, I love the West, North or South, they're both the best, but I'll only go there as a guest, 'cause I love being here with you. I love the sea, I love the shore, I love the rocks, and what is more, with you there, they'd never be a bore, 'cause I love being here with you. Singing in the shower, laughing by the hour. Life is such a breezy game. Love all kinds of weather, long as we're together. I love to hear you say my name. I love good wine and fine cuisine and candlelight. I love that scene, but baby, if you know what I mean.
song. How do you say? I love being here with you. Bass's band is swinging. I love Ella singing. Cause there's something else you know. They know how to say it. They know how to play it. They just wind it up and let it go. I love the thrill.
Everybody.
Thank you, Bernie.
My pleasure.
Bernie. Thank you, JP.
And up next is lasagna. Please welcome to your plate. Welcome to your plate, lasagna, everybody. All righty. Up next is a fabulous new discovery that we got here at the Metropolitan Room. Please help me welcome to the stage the lovely Deborah Stone.
Why, thank you so much. Quick comment here, just something I've noticed. This is my first year in cabaret. As of January, it'll be a year for me, and I'm thrilled. I have an observation. You know all the songs we decide to sing when we do our shows? Well, I realize that the songs pick us. Of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky, the little stars climb, always reminding me that we're apart. You wander down the lane and far. Leaving me a song that will not die. Love is now the stardust of yesterday, the music of the years gone by. Sometimes I wonder why I spend the lonely my reverie, and I am once again with you when our love was new, and each kiss an inspiration. But that was long ago. Now my consolation is in the stardust of a song. Beside a garden wall, when stars are bright, you are in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise where roses grew. Though I dream in vain, in my heart it will remain.
the stars are bright. You are in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise where roses grew. Though I dream in vain, in my heart it will remain. My stardust melody, the memory of love's
Debra Stone, everybody. Well, this party is almost over. How's the lasagna, folks? It's good? Thank you so much. Besides the performers, we also have industry here. We have press. We've got some media folks. So please give them a hand for reviewing your shows. They've done a fabulous job this year. A lot of great reviews in so many different publications. Hi, Don Pat. And I'd also like to acknowledge somebody who's been really a big fan and supporter and has done some fabulous work, and you should really thank him if he's done work for you. Mr. Fred Cohen, right there, who's one of the best photographers on the planet today, living today. He really is. Your shot should be in Life magazine. Is it still around, by the way, Life magazine? No. But they should be in Life magazine if it was still around. Seriously, you've done some fabulous, spot-on shots. So I want to thank you, Fred, for all you've done. Let's bring up to the stage now the lovely and talented Peggy Eason.
There you go. There's a step. There you go. Good.
Wonderful. Who's playing the piano for you? Is it John Delphin? Come on back, John. Did he go to the bathroom?
I was being told a joke. I can't believe you interrupted it.
I did. What joke?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Maybe you know Peggy. By the way, she's also known as the Chocolate Diva. And I love chocolate.
Thank you.
Here you go. Stay right there. Here you go. Here's the microphone. I'm going to put it in stand, as she requested. She doesn't like to hold it. Everybody can see you. No, right here, right here. Here's the mic, and there's the stand, right here.
Is this thing on?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Okay. Am I facing the right direction, guys?
No, turn around.
I'm just joking. When Bernie asked me to sing, I had no idea as to what I was going to sing, and then I saw Oliver, and this inspired me to sing this song. He doesn't act as though he cares, but deep inside, I know he cares. And that is why I'm tied right by his side. He needs me. I know where I must be. I'll cling on steadfastly as long as he needs me. As long as life is long, him right or wrong, and somehow I'll be strong as long as he needs me. When you are lonely, then you will know when someone needs you. Say, I must. I've got to stray true just as long as he needs me. Take it away, John. John Delpin, everybody.
Help her down. Thank you, Peggy Easton, the chocolate diva. Up next, please, help me welcome one of our best friends, an incredible jazz singer who's actually having a conversation in the hallway right now. Please welcome to the stage Sarah Zahn, everybody. Sarah Zahn and her husband on the piano, Alan Kashkin.
Some shoulder surgery about 3 weeks ago, but it's good. It's getting better every day, and I'd like to start out by telling you my favorite Christmas joke. Brother and sister, 4 and 5 years old, respectively, come down the stairs on Christmas morning, and the tree is up, and the presents are under the tree, and so they are looking for the boxes with their names on it. And the little girl finds a box with her name on it, and she opens it up, and it's an Easy Bake oven. It has a light bulb, and it makes cookies and donuts, and she's so excited. And the little boy opens a present with his name on it, and it's a box of crap. But he's optimistic. He keeps looking, you know. The little girl opens a second present with her name on it, and it's a nurse's bag with a stethoscope and a thermometer and a nurse's hat, and she's so excited. The little boy opens his second present with his name on it, and it's another box of crap. So the little girl opens up the third box, and it's a Betsy Wetsy doll. It drinks, it cries, it wets, it's fabulous. And the little boy opens up his third box, and of course, what is it? It's a box of crap. So just then, Grandma comes down the stairs, and she says, oh, good morning, Merry Christmas, children. They said, Merry Christmas, Grandma. She says, I see you're opening your presents. What did you get? And the little girl says, oh, I got an Easy Bake oven with a light bulb that makes cookies, and I got a Betsy Wetsy doll, and she cries, and she drinks, and she wets, and I got a nurse's bag with a stethoscope and a thermometer and a nurse's hat. And the grandmother says, oh, that's so nice. And she said to the little boy, and she says, and what did you get? And he said, I think I got a puppy, but I can't find the frickin' thing. Anyway, I think that would go over better than Lush Life, so. anyway, we were talking about, everybody was talking about songwriters before, and this song is by one of my favorite lyricists, and it's continuing with the optimism, even when you find boxes of crap. I'm going to just leave this here because I don't usually hold the mic with my left hand.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything's starting to hum.
it's real good, but the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? The best is yet to come. Come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly.
Awesome. Thank you, Sarah Zahn and Alan Kashkin.
Hey, before I get off the stage, can I just say one thing?
No.
Who else in this business, besides Bernie and Joanne, do this for us? This and so much more. I mean, you guys are really incredible. JP, fabulous, always. The whole staff here, such a great home, such a great place to be. And nobody treats performers like Bernie and Joanne and the Metropolitan.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you.
Love you.
Your money is waiting for you by the bar. Yes. Okay. The only way to describe your next singer is like 4th of July sparkles and fireworks, I think. Yes. His name is Mr. Tim Moss.
Hello. How are you? Oh, my goodness. So good to see everybody here. What a wonderful celebration. And I agree. Thank you, Bernie and Joanne, just for everything you do throughout the year. Just supplying such a wonderful space. Again, my name is Tim Moss. I was challenged a few years ago to write three songs for a one-person show that I did called Girl, A Lopsided Tree Won't Ruin Christmas. And I rose to the occasion. So I'm loving kind of the theme of this. When the wind gets cooler and the snow's about to blow, I walk around the town that I love so. I love New York at Christmas, friendly faces everywhere. I love New York at Christmas, lots of love for me to share. The windows at Macy's and Bloomie's and Saks makes me feel all warm inside. You can sit on Santa's lap and say what you want, but don't forget to show your pride. Yay! I love New York at Christmas. So many things to do. I love New York at Christmas, and even on New Year's too. Even though all the park trees have all turned to brown, here is something that'll turn that frown upside down. I love New York at Christmas. You can see most anything. I love New York at Christmas. I wonder what Santa will bring. At Rockefeller Center, there's a big old tree that's covered in all kinds of lights. But you can find me all over town, from the Village to Washington Heights. I love New York at Christmas. So many things to do. I love New York at Christmas, and even on New Year's too. From the Bronx and Yankee Stadium to Coney Island's Brooklyn shore, from Queens and Staten Island, there's nothing I love more. In the harbor is Lady Liberty, who says, we are all free. And now, with marriage equality, that even includes me. Come on, kids, let's have a big Broadway-style ending. Okay. I love New York at Christmas. The couture does abound. I love New York at Christmas. God, I really get around. You know, there's no dealers, addicts, or prostitutes on 42nd Street no more. 'Cause it's all been sold to Disney, the new whore. Just saying. We have to end this at Times Square, or we'll surely have regrets. But don't you have any fear, my friends. I have my own Rockettes. Everybody now. I love New York at Christmas. So many things to do. I love New York at Christmas, and even on New Year's too. One more time. I love New York at Christmas. So many things to do. I love New York at Christmas, and even on New Year's too. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Mr. Tim Moss. And before we bring up our final closing act at this great, incredible party, I'm going to invite somebody to the stage who will share his thoughts about his series here at the Metropolitan Room. And he's working his way up to the stage. He knows who he is. And he's only going to do it in 140 characters. Right, Stephen? Thank you. Please give it up for Stephen Hanks.
Hey, everybody. Well, is this the one working?
Is this the one? This is the one. This is the moment. Who else is left? Anyone? Hey, everybody. Happy holidays and happy new year. It has been, I think we'd all agree, that it has been really a fabulous year until November 8th. Right? Right? That's when the year ended for me. And my life is going to be over on January 20th. Save me, Peggy. Save me. Okay. So just want to do two things. I have a short agenda. I want to talk a little bit about the series that Bernie graciously offered me to do a few years ago that I think has become a fairly nice success. But first I wanted to do, I'm going to do a flip on what people usually do when they do shows, where they do thank yous at the end. I have a lot of thank yous because there's some people in this room who are very important to me and who've been important to the creation of the series and in everything that I've done in cabaret, and I want to acknowledge them, especially at this time of year. And in no particular order, because as I've told Bernie many times, do not invite me up to speak after I've had four glasses of
140 characters. 140 characters are almost up.
So in order to get an extra 140 characters, I'm going to thank Bernie Firshpan and his wife, Joanne.
You're welcome.
And Joseph and JP. And although I would love to mention all of them by name, and I probably shouldn't say this, and Joanne, are you here? There you go. Hey, Joanne. Although I would love to introduce them by name, I don't have enough time, I shouldn't say this, because the people that work in all of the cabaret rooms in the city are pretty terrific, but I have to say this because it's true, and I spend a lot of time here. The staff at the Metropolitan Room is the best staff in New York. The people that do the people that work the front of the room, the people that work the bars, the wait staff, they're all tremendous. I've loved them ever since I started coming to this room. And I also want to thank a very important person. I don't know how many of you know, I actually started in cabaret as a reviewer. I did that for 4 years until I came to my senses and decided to, I wanted to make a couple of dollars doing this stuff. But the person that gave me my start as a cabaret reviewer at Cabaret Scenes is the great Peter Levy. And I repaid him by jumping to Broadway World, right? Okay, so I also want to thank, I've got a little enclave over there in the corner of various clients and people that have done the New York Cabaret's Greatest Hit series. I want to acknowledge that whole crew in the corner over there. Some of my clients, Charlotte Patton, Tom Tose, and people that have done the series, Deb Berman, Janice Hall. They're all over there. Mark Nadler was also part of it. And is Pamela Lewis, and Laurie Krauss, who's coming on, was also in the series this year, and Pamela Lewis is at the bar. So New York Cabaret's Greatest Hits brings back shows of the past, terrific shows that won awards or were highly reviewed, were very critically acclaimed shows. And just really quickly, next season, we're going to do 8 shows next year. The first one is going to be on February 13th at 7 o'clock, and it's going to be Jenna Esposito doing her great, what's the show? Now I forgot the show, Connie Francis tribute show. See, I told you, 4 glasses of champagne. Now the second show is going to be Adam Shapiro's Guide to the Perfect Breakup, which on the cards outside, and you should all pick them up, says March 13th, but I booked that before I knew that the Bistro Awards was going to be that night. So we're moving it to March 15th. All the shows are at 7 o'clock. It's going to be a great season. We're going to have Colm Riley, Sarah Rice. Pamela Lewis is going to do December next year. Her great show, Daddy's Little Girl, is going to be in December. Right, Pam? It's going to be great. All right. So get the cards. You'll see the whole schedule. I want to thank you very much for allowing me to talk to you, and have a great holiday.
Mr. Stephen Hanks, and up next is a closer that's going to knock your socks off. I'm talking about the socks, you know, on the fireplace, those kind of socks. All right, everybody, please give it up for Laurie Krauss and Daryl Kojak.
Too much pressure. You do realize I always close these things for you, Bernie. I did the, what was that, like, record-setting thing? I was here at 6:45 in the morning singing. So I'm not being rude. I have my phone for a reason. So I was going, this is Daryl Kojak over here. Daryl and I, you know, we did our 25th anniversary show, and for 25 years, whenever I get my way, not as opposed to him, he loves this too, we close with the song we're going to close with here now. It's my favorite song. I think it's really brilliant right now. And I was going to introduce it in another way, but then a friend posted something on Facebook and I decided I was going to share this. The world has gone mad in so many ways. And I was going to talk about that, which I obviously just did, but I was going to say other things. But then the lovely and talented Charlotte Patton, who I did not say I was going to say this, posted this Tennessee Williams quote on Facebook today. And so I decided, God willing, I can see it, that this will be my intro. And he said, "The world is violent and mercurial. It will have its way with you. We are saved only by love. Love for each other and the love that we pour into the art we feel compelled to share." Being a parent, being a writer, being a painter, being a friend, we live in a perpetually burning building. And what we must save from it all the time is love. And I want to thank Bernie and Joanne for doing that very thing for us this evening. Daryl Kojak. You've got to give a little and take a little and let your poor heart break a little. That's the story of that is the glory of love. You've got to laugh a little and cry a little before the clouds roll. That's the story of that is the glory of love. As long as there's the two of us, we've got the world and all of its charms. And when the world is through with us, we've got each other's arms. You've got to win a little and lose a little and always have blues a little. That's the story of that is the glory of love. Thank you.
It has long as there's the two of us, we've got the world and all of its charms. And when the world is through with us, we've got each other's arms. You've got to win a little and lose just a little, and always, always, always have the blues a little. That's the story of that is the glory of love. That is the story and the glory.
Of love.
Ladies and gentlemen, Larry Krause.
And that's the story of love, folks. I just want to tell you a little story, if you don't mind. Let me tell you a little story of mine. No matter, thank you, Joseph. Joseph Maki, everybody.
Everybody.
No matter how bad things get, it's all relative. My father witnessed the murder of his entire family, 5 siblings and 2 parents, and lived in the forest at age 10, for 2.5 years as a Holocaust survivor. And after all that, he still loved. And he loved me and my brother and his wife, my mother. They're gone now, but they left a legacy for me to look at life from the positive point of view. So no matter how bad you say it is, you are lucky. You're in the greatest country on the planet. We have so much to be grateful for. Keep thinking positive. Do great things, because life's too short. Do great things, folks. I'm giving you the stage to do great things. Just do it. Let's share the love. I want my staff. My staff, can you come up here? Mark, Riyadh, Chris, get up here. Everybody that works for me, get up here now.
Come
Joanne,
on,
honey, I work for you, honey. I work for you. Don't worry.
Come on,
get up
JP,
here.
JP.
Everybody, get up here. Everybody, I want you to see my step, JP. This is my staff. This is my beautiful staff who I adore. And it's not all of them. We have a large... We have 30 people working here who love all of you.
I'm dressed for you tonight.
Who love all of you. This is my incredible wife who made dinner for you tonight. Joseph, you have a few words?
Just a few things. I hope you'll
Peter.
Spend... Yes, Peter, come up here with
come
us.
Come up here,
You're
Peter.
You're part of this family. This Thursday, please join us for Liz Lomax. She's actually here tonight. I hope you're going to share New Year's Eve with us. Marilyn May is going to ring in 2017. And I hope you'll be back next year for many, many great things here at the Metropolitan Room. I have the great pleasure of calling this people up on stage my family. They are my family, and they have been through with me a lot of things this year. If I can get through what I've gotten through this year, as many of you know, we can all get through so many things. Thank you for your love and support.
And don't forget to see Liz's show, Liz Lomax.
7 o'clock.
Coming up, she's amazing. We have you're all amazing. Don't you forget it. You're all amazing. You got some great things to do. So I want to thank everybody. Did I thank everybody? Yeah. Honey, did I do the right thing? Peter, thank you. Okay, great. Love you all. Thank you for sharing this party with us. We'll see you 2017. Let's have a blast. Think positive.
Good night, everyone.